Huge capital requirements often prevent people from starting their own business. But money reasons should not force you to give up on your dream of becoming an entrepreneur. So today, we'll find out how leasing may be the key to help you realize your entrepreneurial goals. I'm Edric Mendoza, and this is On The Money. With us today is Andre Angelo Santos, or Dino, Vice President and Head of Leasing at the Bank of the Philippine Islands. Hi, Dino.
Hey, hi, Edric.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Really excited to hear this whole concept of leasing.
Yes, yes.
For me personally, it's actually a new idea, even if I am in business. Can you help expound, define the concept of leasing,
right,
at least in a business sense,
yes,
here?
Well, leasing as a structure, no, is a structure of financing where the lessor or the financing company or the leasing company purchases an asset and leases it out to a lessee over a period of time at a certain interest rate.
Okay.
All right. Now, there are two types of leases, if I may say. Mm-hmm. One is the operating lease, where the lessee treats it purely as an expense.
Okay.
It is off their books. It is on our books as the leasing company or the financing company. And the other way is the finance lease or capital lease, where it is on their books. They book the asset on their books. At the same time, they also have a share of that depreciation.
Right.
And that is now paid to us. There is no mortgage fees because the asset is already under the name of the financing company.
Right. So much like land, right?
Yes.
Much like land. If I am to borrow land and rent and be a tenant, then it's just an expense to me.
Correct.
Whereas if I buy it, naturally the asset is under my, or at least in my books, and then I pay the depreciation. Very similar to that.
Very similar. The only difference is, Edric, is at the end of the term on a finance lease, the asset becomes yours.
That's beautiful.
Yes.
Right. So let's talk about that.
Yes.
Maybe I think to help expound on it, what sort of items can be covered by this type of lease?
Right. Well, we say that it is anything that is durable, anything that is insurable, anything that is identifiable, and anything that is saleable,
Time-tested, maybe.
Time-tested. Yeah. Right. 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 And it is accessible just in case
the bank needs to take it,
or the customer would like to return
the item. So what would be examples of these types of leasable items?
Yes.
For example?
Well, in the portfolio of our financing company, the largest piece of equipment would be transportation.
Or vehicles.
No, you have delivery trucks, you have passenger cars, you have forklifts, you have
construction
type of equipment, right?
Vehicles,
but what we're looking at and what has really increased in volume, although it offers half of the portfolio of our leasing company, is high value equipment like machineries, industrial machineries.
Industrial.
Right. Plastic forming material, plastic forming machines, CNC machines. We also are heavy now into construction equipment.
Right.
You have the bulldozers, the payloaders, and the like.
Right.
You also have a lot of medical equipment that has recently increased in portfolio.
Clinics, operations like that?
Not really clinics, but large hospitals as well.
Okay.
The portfolio of our leasing company in medical equipment is in the 1.3 billion area today.
Out of a total of?
A total of around 10 billion.
Wow. And so it's almost 10%.
Right. And that's the type of equipment that is being leased there, are MRI machines, CT scans, X-ray machines, mammogram equipment and the like.
Companies can actually opt to lease those items because this is not offered to an individual currently.
Yes, at the moment we're concentrating on corporate accounts.
Right.
And then we're looking at a partnership, as,
right,
as I mentioned to you earlier, about looking at the proposing a better value proposition to our corporate clients by packaging both a loan together with a lease.
And
there's so many benefits for that, Edric. You know, when you do a loan and a lease, you're effectively and efficiently booking certain assets in order to have a very good balance sheet that's able to make you have better funding solutions.
Sure, sure.
Right?
So let's translate that to a specific example.
Yeah.
If for example, I have I want to now set up a car fleet as a business, and I now go for leasing as an option, and the total cost I need is about $1 million, what part can you now shoulder there, which will now be leased?
Yes.
And which part do I have to have to pay,
all
if
right,
ever?
For example, you're a startup company.
Sure.
And usually the equity or the guarantee deposit goes anywhere from 10 to 20%,
okay,
depending on the credit viability of your project.
Right, about 100,000 or 200,000, if that's the example.
Right, okay. And then what the financing company comes in, we finance the 80 or 90%.
Wonderful.
We spread it out over a period of 3 to 5 years.
Okay.
Now, for example, you're a larger business and you have a pool of cars within your fleet. What I can do is we can propose to you that we will have your fleet appraised and we can now buy that and sell that back to you, or lease that back to you, for a certain amount of time.
Right. So that is one option.
Yes.
You can buy it from me and then lease it back to me. The other option is you can buy it straight out when I start up and then lease it to me.
Correct.
So let's look at that lease setup. So I'm now leasing from you. And I shouldered 10 to 20% of the total amount needed.
Right.
What is the effective interest to me that I'll have to pay over the 3 to 5 year term?
The effective interest rate looks like it comes out to anywhere from 8 and 8.5 all the way to around 12.5.
Okay.
Right.
And that would be locked in for the 3 to 5 years?
We can work on a fixed rate for that amount.
Right.
And as today's interest rates are quite flat.
Right.
We can you know, work
quite
on something that is fixed.
Right. And so the advantage there for me, let's say I'm starting up, I'm Juan de la Cruz, here I go. The cash out for me, apart from the accounting treatment, the cash out for me would be much less.
Of course. Especially
instead of pulling out all that money.
Yeah, at the same time, what we failed to stress, what is in lease, there is no mortgage fees. Because ultimately the asset is under the name of the financing company.
Owned by the financing company. Wonderful. Mm-hmm. So the only real cost to me is paying that monthly rental. And it's a monthly rental.
Yes, it's a monthly rental.
Okay. Right. And you want to highlight again, earlier you were saying how one of the big benefits as well is after the term of the lease, the asset is mine.
Leasing really,
can you explain that?
Leasing really focuses at the onset on the monthly amortization.
Sure.
But also, we also look at the residual value of the asset itself at the end of the term. Mm-hmm. And usually, the guaranteed deposit that you give at the start will reverse and be applied to the payment for the equipment at the end.
The requirements for a person to opt
something like this? It's exactly the same as the loan. We have all the documentary requirements that we get.
Is it as stringent as a standard business loan, for
same,
example?
It's the same because we look at it as a credit facility.
I see.
As far as the bank is concerned, it's a credit facility.
But the difference between this and a business loan, a straightforward business loan, is tell me about the collateral involved.
Oh, the collateral, as we mentioned in a lease, the collateral is the equipment itself.
There you go. Any other differences that you want to call out between this scenario and other loans that people can avail of? What would make this an advantage?
One advantage for this, I think, is when companies would like to expand. And when companies would like to expand, it is now an alternative funding source. Mm. And that's where we see leasing going. And now and in the future, I feel that leasing is going to really kick in terms of volume. Mm-hmm. No? A lot of other leasing companies in the Philippines have been growing by leaps and bounds. And as the economy moves forward, leasing becomes an alternative solution. Mm-hmm. And I think it's really a smart choice.
Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah, and I can see that.
Yeah.
No, I mean, it covers different areas.
Yes.
So I think what I'd like to ask last, as we close this time, is where else would it be headed? Who else are you trying to reach with this particular package?
Well, at the moment, you know, we're trying to replicate and we're trying to tie up with all the other clients of the bank. And trying
already
clients
in
of the
loans.
Bank in loans, and we're trying to tandem the leasing as something that can add value to the lending facility offered to them.
Sure.
And that is something we are doing now, and we see that in 2013 to be very active.
Business people, particularly.
Yes, right.
Excellent. And you're seeing yourself going to retail eventually?
Well, eventually retail will come in.
Okay.
It's something that has not yet been probably, I would say, something that the leasing companies have not been looking at the moment. Mm-hmm. But as the economy picks up and more people are qualified for leases, and I think it's headed that way because in other countries, leasing is already gone retail.
Wonderful. You know, Dino, we're going to have more questions for you.
All right.
Very interesting topics. But right now, we have to pause for a short break, so stay with us. On the Money, we'll be right back. Welcome back to On The Money. Let's now hear what Salve Duplito has for us today in Salve Says.
Here's my countdown on why 2012 is unforgettable.
She was once described as a one-woman financial advice powerhouse by USA Today and is known for her tough love on television. Just this month, Congress passed the Air Passenger Bill of Rights, giving you protection against nightmares like offloaded baggage, overbooked flights, misleading ads, flight delays, and cancellations. So, know your rights. 2012 has just been great for those who invested in real estate. OFWs are buying houses, high-rise condominiums continue to dominate the skylines, and a lot of you probably bought or made money by selling. Some mutual funds gave as much as 38% one-year returns, and unit-linked investment trust funds, or UITFs, gave as much as 34% in the third quarter. They are riding the boom of the economy and have made many investors happy. But remember, historical returns do not guarantee future ones. Keep that in mind.
Inflation is the rate by which prices of basic goods and commodities increase. It's the number that you have to beat to make sure your money doesn't lose value over time. It's a silent killer of your nest egg. That's why the continuous downtrend of inflation is a big development in 2012.
Some banks have started to offer home loans as low as 6% per annum because of the low interest rates this year. And that frees up a lot of the cash previously earmarked for mortgage payments. Overall, they are not as great as the almost 10% payouts in 2011. But hey, the highest, which is at 8.6% by Ginebra San Miguel, is not that bad. That's considering dividends are just one of two ways you earn from stocks.
Amon Futures stung investors, but it also taught people to stay away from scams. The price that we had to pay for this mistake was 12 billion pesos in hard-earned money, a lot of which were borrowed. So people, stay away from Ponzi scams.
Those who have the stomach for riskier investments in the stock market have raked in winnings this year. The Philippine Stock Exchange just kept breaching record highs. Again, this is not a guarantee that everything will go north in the future. GDP is the sum of goods and products that exchange hands in the economy at a specific period of time. Think of it as the income of the entire country. At 7.1%, we are just a shining light in the world right now. More fun in the Philippines.
2012 is a memorable year for those who follow personal finance developments. But the best in this countdown is the birth of ANC's personal finance show. We aim to serve you because you deserve to be always on the money.
Still with us is Andre Angelo Santos, or Dino, Vice President and Head of Leasing at the Bank of the Philippine Islands. Hi, Dino.
Hi.
Mel, what questions do we have for Dino today?
We have a few questions for you, but actually before we start, I have a question. What is the difference in the monthly between loaning and leasing the same item?
Okay. The amount financed is broken down in amortization schedule, which is the same as a loan or a lease. Mm-hmm. The only difference is within the interest rate. Okay. The interest rates for leasing is slightly higher than what you would get as a rate for the corporate lending. If the corporate lending side is doing anywhere from 4.5 to 7, leasing rates would vary anywhere from 8, 8.5 to 12.5.
Okay. Great, yes. But you don't have those loan fees.
No, we don't have mortgage fees.
Okay.
Because ultimately the asset is under the name of the bank, mm-hmm. and because it's under the name of the bank, there's none of that, and that's 2.5% of the face amount, roughly calculated.
Right. Okay. Great. Thanks, Dino. Yeah. Anyway, our first question comes from Marcus, who said, "I inherited a property from my parents, which is in a good enough commercial area. It's largely unused except for a part that's rented out. What are my options to make money out of it aside from selling the property? Can I tap a bank or real estate broker to lease and manage it for me?"
Yeah, that's possible. I think in today's economy's outlook, which is very positive, the highest multiple for gain, I think, is in property.
Okay, right. And is it better to go with a broker or a bank?
I think the bank looks at it as part of an asset that the person would like to provide him mm-hmm. for a business opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
A broker is somebody that would find a possible rental income for him.
Yes.
So right.
I guess he can actually, I think, go to both.
Okay, our next question comes from Farah, who says, my parents recently purchased some equipment from China for their printing business, but now they want to sell the business to finance my education since I got accepted into an expensive university overseas. I feel terrible about this. Is there anything they can do so they can keep their business and still get me into college abroad? Personally, I have no problem going to college here. What a sweet daughter.
So. Right. Very selfless, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
I guess the opportunities for them is to go to a leasing company.
Sure.
Like us. And for us to appraise the value of the
equipment.
Mm-hmm. And the value of the equipment can be given to the company. And probably the pursuit of her dreams of studying abroad may because
of the cash advantage, right? Instead of the parents spending all the money, they spread it out. They can use that time to also pay for the college in installments.
In fact, we are telling our clients that if you are going to purchase equipment, it's wiser to do it through a leasing company,
sure,
so that you can plan your expenditure. You know, you can spread it out,
right?
Unlike importing it directly from abroad, where you have to pay 100% right away of the value.
Interesting. Are there also negotiation deals you're able to do if they go straight to the financing company?
Well, usually the financing companies also have very good relationships with the vendors, and so because of that, the vendors usually give very, very good deals, you know, that the leasing company can now participate in.
Good to know.
Okay, great. Next question comes from Dong, who asks, my OFW contract will end next year and I am looking forward to going home and growing our small business. In the last years that I was in United Arab Emirates, I had my wife start a vegetable trading business. We get vegetables from source and deliver to customers. We've been using a small owner type Jeep, but our orders have grown bigger and it will be better to get a bigger truck than have the small Jeep make many trips. Can we lease even just for one or two trucks? What is the minimum amount to lease? I really want to have cash on hand for the many other little expenses of growing a business. That's a very good question and a good option.
Yeah, leasing is possible. At the moment, the thrust of the leasing company is to look at an asset size of anywhere from 10 to 20 million, because that will be able to justify the credit facility as well as the monthly amortizations. But moving forward, I think it's going to be moving towards retail. And once the retail option is out, I think people will be able to use leasing for types of endeavors like these. Mm-hmm.
So mm-hmm. why is leasing cars in this country not so popular? Because it's so prevalent elsewhere. And it's a really good way to either have a new car or own a car eventually.
Right.
Yeah,
I think the Philippines is catching up because in the recent newspaper dailies, you have large luxury brands proposing leasing opportunities, and I think it's headed towards that area. We are looking at the possibility of having certain cars under a lease program as well at our leasing company.
Mm-hmm.
If you lease the car, how long do you normally lease
for? Usually it goes from anywhere from 3 to 5 years.
Okay. And then after that 3-year period, can't you just upgrade to another car?
Well, the way it's structured today is at the end of the 3 to 5 years, the car goes back to you. You own it.
Okay.
Many times in the U.S., the car at the end of 3 to 5 years, under certain stipulations, the car is owned by the car company.
Yes.
And therefore, what is only financed is a portion of the vehicle.
Exactly.
Right.
Is that something that wouldn't be popular here?
I'm sure it would be popular. Mm. I think it's up to the car dealers and distributors to take a more active role in the financing of these.
What's the upside for those people who would be leasing these cars?
Well,
of having which option, either the one where you own it after 3 years or the one where you buy it or you upgrade.
Okay. Well, in other countries such as the US, you're able to lease cars under certain mileage stipulations.
Okay. And meaning,
And meaning you can't go
you can't exceed
a certain miles in a year. Mm-hmm. At the same time, you're not allowed to customize the car.
Cannot fix it.
You cannot.
Yeah, because it's correct. It's the property.
It's purely for usage.
Right.
And when if the need is purely usage, then that opportunity I think is possible here. And I think it's something that
that will make the barriers much lower into getting a vehicle for people starting up.
Exactly.
It's something we can explore. Definitely. Which leads to my follow-up question. The 10 to 20 million that you gave earlier, that's a strict requirement.
Well,
meaning any asset amount less than that is not something that is
I would say that is just the market that we're looking at.
At this point. Yes. But you can go lower.
Yes, of course. Okay. Of course.
Good to know.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now our next question comes from Calvin, who says, my best friend was successful in business. I was encouraged to set up my own. We are fairly successful now, but the payment terms of our suppliers is straining our cash flow. Mm. My friend recommended I get a lease on the new machines we just bought. I am all for this, but how long will processing take? I need to know so I can review my options.
Okay, I guess what she's talking about is an opportunity, what we call sale and lease back. Because they've already purchased the equipment is already under the name. What we do is we send a team of appraisers, look at the machines, put a value on them, and do the processing, which takes around 2.5 weeks. So in 2.5 weeks, we can provide them with
That's fairly quick.
With the financing for the amount that is less the equity or the guaranteed deposit that you're going to have to put up.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. So that's a fast process, faster than a loan.
Yes, right. More or less the same.
Well, it depends. If you're buying land,
depends on where you
you have to go through certain government organizations.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, so it looks like leasing is actually a great option to buying outright or getting a loan.
Right, right. We feel that leasing is here, and leasing is a very wise option to take. And I think leasing not only being wise, it's also a very a good alternative to financing certain equipment.
Sure. Do you know, I may not have caught this, but in the sale and lease back, so like in this particular question's case, when they appraise the items, Is there any way to verify that?
We have in the bank we have a group of appraisers that have been certified,
right?
And they look at the value of the equipment.
I see.
And we consider them to be more or less third party because they belong to a different segment, a different group.
Okay, great. Thank you, Dino.
All right, you're very welcome.
Send us your money questions via email, Facebook, or Twitter, and we'll try to answer them in our upcoming episodes or on our next Q&A Friday.
Very interesting option, especially for those setting up or into their businesses already, right?
Yes.
Leasing for cash purposes, especially.
Exactly. Yes.
Great option and even a compliment.
Right.
So great discussions.
Right.
Thanks again, Dino. Mel,
thank you.
That's our show today. I'm Edric Mendoza. Join us again tomorrow for more talking tips so you're always right on the money.